Hello, I got some issues with window motor, and it's don't moving. Window is not moving, not open, not close, and it's right now its engine is on. So I'm planning to change it, and this is front passenger side for 2006 Nissan Xterra. I'm gonna use this type of tools. I'm gonna use this extension. And I'm gonna use 10 millimeter socket. I also gonna use, I'm not sure the proper name for it, but this flat bar screw driver, this one. And I also gonna use this screwdriver. I might gonna use it. So to open it, to get inside the motor, you need to remove this plastic cover. And this is just one way to do it. You need to disconnect this switch, just like that. And next step is just to remove this arm holder. And next step would be to remove this side, this opener. So just same way. This side. The same inside cover. You need to remove inside cover, just like this. This is metal. I don't have plastic one, so in my case, I make some tiny scratches for a plastic. So just in case, if you would like to have it, no scratches, better to use some plastic tools. To open these covers. Next step is just take your extension. Take your extension and open this. Unscrew these sides. This one and this one. So you have right one piece of screw behind these covers. So you have one piece, which is right in this side. You have second piece right in this side. Second piece, and you have third piece right. This is gonna be your third piece. So next step, carefully to pull it. I would suggest to try to pull it from corners. So just when you open it from bottom part, just lift it to the top. Lift it lightly. Lift it because it has holder which is going right inside. So you cannot pull it this way. You need to pull it bottom and after up. So I'm just gonna keep this plastic on the side. Next step would be to open the sides. So same way, you just gonna unscrew this, 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 and this. You need to take to keep it in memory how to put it back, because you can twist it opposite side. Impossible to do this, and just it would not be possible to put your mount back. So just take picture before removing it to keep it on memory. So I'm gonna just keep it in this way. Same. I'm gonna keep it. I'm gonna put all screws inside. And next step would be to remove this plastic, I'm not sure what's the name for it, but this cover. Okay, so in this case you need to be carefully pull it. So this is your protection cover. This one, black glue, it's original. It's from manufacture. This gray one, it's butyl tape. I used it last year because original one become not sticky anymore. So I just used this type of tape. It comes I think it's 1 inch, or it comes as 3/4 size, and I just cut it in a half. I cut it in a half, and I put it on top of original tape, and it works very nice. It's gonna be always sticky for many years, and it's not afraid of oils. So just, and oils and dirt, it's gonna stick very well, just like that. So next, this is location for your motor. Right in this corner, it's your motor, and I need to put it back. And after your next step, try to move your window down so that just one moment, you're gonna see. You need to remove security and security from a window, so you need to move it down to this level. You need to move your window right direct to this level where you have this hole, so that you can untie your assembly. To do this, to make your old motor moving, just to try to hit it from some directions. So in my case, window is not moving at all. In my case, window is not moving at all. And what's one more options to make it move? You just hit this area. some light hits, and after like this. So your main main thing to make it move, right to this point, so that you would see this two screws, this one and this one, so that you need to remove window first. You need to remove this screws. So after I just gonna again disconnect this side. And after again with extension, I gonna unscrew it. First, give me a second. This is going to be second. After I just gonna disconnect window motor connection for a power, it's right in this position. Like this, I remove it, I'm gonna put it on the side. And after, next step, just to secure your window. Next step would be to secure your window. I'm going to use this tape, this duct tape. So just in this way, I would suggest to put more of tape. I'm just gonna be trying to finish this process very fast, so I hope it's not gonna fall down. Next step, after you secure your window, you need to remove these two screws. And after these two screws, this is for your lift. When you remove it, after step, you need to remove this window motor screws. It's gonna be three pieces. So just use this one. Next step, you need to use your two hands. First hand, you're gonna lift these grooves for a motor. You have these tiny grooves which keeps motor inside. So you need to take it from both sides, like that. You need to hold it, and with the second hand, you need to take your lift. This is gonna be old motor. And the next step, I just gonna open this box, which I just received with a new motor. Make sure that it's gonna be for the left side, front right side for a passenger. Let's install it. To put this motor back, you need to get some patience. You need to get some patience and carefully. Carefully you need to put it back. So same. I put these grooves back for a motor so that it's gonna hold on place. And as you can see, it has all holes aligned with the window lift. I need to adjust this side. So just as you can see, right now it's aligned. So we're gonna put it back. And always keep looking for your tape. If you're using tape to secure window, always keep looking so that it's not gonna get removed slowly, so that it's not gonna fall down and not gonna crash. So this side I just put it light, and same for the bottom. I not tight it all the way down. I just want to align, to put all screws back, and only after I'm gonna tight it. And same for a motor. Sorry, this is for a motor side. Side is ready. Now I just finger tightened the screws. Same for this side. And same for the bottom. And now I'm gonna give light. I'm gonna screw it. Just like this. Same for the top side. And same for the motor. Next step, I'm just gonna lock it on. And after I'm gonna put my switch back. And I'm gonna... Yeah, I'm gonna check it. And as you can see, it works very nicely. This side is moving. So what next step? I'm gonna go up. Or actually no, I'm gonna keep it on next step. I'm gonna keep it on this side. And now I'm gonna lightly move my mirror. Oh, sorry, not mirror, my glass. I'm gonna move it down so that it's gonna land right to this lift. Just like this. As long as I can see these grooves, I'm holding glass. You need to not make mistake. You need to put this type of screws inside. Not to put not to put mistaken one. So I'm just gonna tight it. And same for that side. I'm gonna tight it up. Like this, I'm gonna give it nice tightness. Like this, and same from the side. So, and now I'm just gonna lift it all the way up. Yeah, and it works good, and it's perfect time to us to put all parts back. So I'm just gonna put it same way as I removed it. Thank you.